Hey guys, how's it going? It's Eve, and for the past few days, a major update was released onto the Singularity test server that affects the way nullification works on the following ships: Interceptors, Blockade Runners, Covert Ops Frigates, Deep Space Transports, Luxury Yachts, Strategic Cruisers, Tech 1 and Faction Frigates, Stealth Bombers, and Shuttles. Current fittings of all the listed ships will need to be changed to meet the new module requirements, providing you have the modules installed. The new limits are one warp core stabilizer or one nullification module per ship. Interceptors, luxury yachts, and nullification propulsion subsystems on Tech 3 cruisers will have the passive nullification stat removed and will be given a new rule bonus. 50% reduced target range penalty and reactivation delay for interdiction nullification modules, 100% increased duration for the interdiction nullification module. All shuttles will be receiving a new stat, the passive nullification, meaning they will no longer be tackled by bubbles and will function as interceptors or luxury yachts that have been nullified in the past expansion. There are 4 new modules being released in the Great Escape update that is coming out later in May. Interdiction Nullifier Tech 1, Compact Interdiction Nullifier, Restrained Interdiction Nullifier, and Interdiction Nullifier Tech 2. Interdiction Nullifier Tech 1 is a low slot module, requires 1 megawatt of power grid, CPU 38 teraflops required to fit, active time is 10 seconds, cooldown of 150 seconds, activation cost of 150 gigajoules, target range penalty of 50%, scan resolution penalty of 50%, max amount fitted is 1, and you will require warp drive operation 4 to fit the module. The difference between the compact and restrained interdiction nullifiers is the CPU requirement for fitting, 32 teraflops and 38 teraflops of CPU required respectively. Now for the Tech 2 nullifier, once again it is a low slot module, power grid requirement is 1 megawatt, CPU of 46 teraflops required to fit, active time is 15 seconds, cooldown of 150 seconds, activation cost of 150 gigajoules, targeting range penalty of 50%, scan resolution penalty 50%, max amount fitted of 1, and you will require the Warp Drive Operation Level 5 skill in order to use the new module. There's one more change coming to Warp Core Stabilizers. The penalty to ship performance will remain as a passive effect of this module, and only warp strength will improve when this module is active. The stats for the Warp Core Stabilizers are activation cost of 50 gigajoules, active duration of 20 seconds, cooldown time of 120 seconds, warp strength increase of 1, targeting range reduction minus 50%, scan resolution reduction of minus 50%, drone bandwidth reduction of minus 50%. Both the nullification module and the warp core stabilizer are now active modules instead of being passive. Once their cycle begins, they cannot be turned off until they have ran their full duration. These new modules can be activated while cloaked by a Stargate. These changes are currently live on the Singularity test server and available for testing right now, with a release stated for later this month. If you would like to provide feedback to the change, a link to the forum post will be in the description below. That's all for this video, guys. Fly dangerous. Peace.
Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you liked this video, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. You guys can check out my other previous videos by clicking the two thumbnails on screen right now. And if you've enjoyed this video and would like to see more, go ahead and click on that subscribe button. Fly dangerous. Peace.